judgment to the USA. That is the focus now. Heaven is focused there, has focused his messengers there right now. And the Lord is demanding for repentance, that they may repent. Repentance is a good thing. Because when you repent, it opens a gateway for you to enter into the glorious kingdom of God Almighty. So that's why you see the Lord Almighty coming out and commanding them to repent. Literally commanding them to repent. The Lord is speaking on a daily basis about striking them with an earthquake. Striking them, the capital city, Washington D.C. He talked about the Washington Monument. Then after he spoke in the dream, it tumbled down. The next, the National Cathedral, where the president, everybody, their leaders go to church. Then again, broke it down with earthquake. I see the left side of it totally collapse. And then I think the other part follows suit, the part remains. And then, but the left side goes down. My right side, which is their left side, when I'm looking at the cathedral, it's my right side. The monument falls towards the left, my left, a little bit at an angle this way. And then now, of course, the Capitol Hill, the dome, the center of power, also the right hand side as I face it collapses from the earthquake. So the Lord is very serious. He's very relentless and consistent. And so right now, he has directed his servants towards the USA constantly, consistently, all the time. Which means this event will take place. This judgment, you see now almost three times, meaning it has been decided in heaven that judgment must take place. And so it's a dreadful thing, a terrible thing for the Lord to cause me to face a nation. It's unbelievable. What is going to happen there will be unbelievable. The Lord has turned his two prophets to face them. And that is the most dreadful thing ever that can happen to a nation. This past night, in that dream, the man you know, when he asked me to turn my face towards the nation of the USA, the United States of America, when I turned my face, the man you know, that was similar to when he turned his face to face Sodom and Gomorrah. I have seen it. It's very fearful. But repentance is always good. And only repentance can open a gateway for anyone to enter the glorious kingdom of God Almighty. And that's why, if the Lord is urging the USA to repent, then you could turn it another way and say that the Lord is loving them. He has seen that they are on the wrong course. They are going to self-destruction. So he has remembered them and he wants them now to come back into the right path that goes to the kingdom of God Almighty. The USA needs to repent because of what is going on there. What is going on in the USA is homosexuality, sexual sin that God Almighty has raised. At the same time, the Lord has raised the fallen church. The rotten church, you see, in the USA, that is spewing out the gospel of prosperity and is not preparing the sheep of Christ for the kingdom of God. So the Lord has remembered his sheep because they are not considering his sheep. And that's why you see the Lord is moving in to fight for the church, fight for the sheep. The reason the Lord is judging the USA is because of what you see in the church. Because the pastors there, they are false prophets there, they are false apostles there, they are false evangelists there, false teachers there, they are false prophets there, prophesying to them good things, and false apostles, apostasy entered in. They think once you're born again, there is this universal security of salvation, And then the Bible says something else. Work out your faith on a daily basis. Jesus himself says, pick up your cross on a daily basis. It's a daily event. And so the Lord has been watching all this. And time has come now when the Lord has deemed it right that the nation of the USA must now repent. Remember, Jesus created all nations, and if the Messiah is coming, then every nation has to submit. Every nation has to come under the authority and the jurisdiction of the announcement on the coming of the Messiah. And that's why right now you saw the relentless conversation the Lord is having with the USA, whereby the first time in the dream he tells me, turn your face and face the nation of the United States of America. And when I turn my face, then he commands them to repent. And I see that they fail to repent, and then he commands me now to strike them in the dream. And then when I strike them with an earthquake, you see the Washington Monument collapse, then it tumbles, the pieces tumble, they break into small pieces. That's their national icon, that is the Washington Monument. You know, just that general area is a known area where they have serious occasions there. And then after that, you see again the Lord comes in the dream the day after that and speaks with me again about this matter, this issue of repentance in USA. And then again I see that they fail to repent, and the Lord asks me to turn my face, to face them, to face the nation of the USA, the United States of America. And as I turn my face, meaning they have caught his attention at that time, they have now caught his attention. As I turn my face towards them like this, the National Cathedral collapses. But from where I'm looking at the National Cathedral, my right hand side of that cathedral door that collapses first. So I don't know whether the entire thing will collapse eventually, but the right hand side is the one that collapses of the National Cathedral in Washington District of Columbia, Washington DC. And then after that, again this night, the Lord comes and raises this same issue of the need for USA to repent from homosexuality, the LGBTQ, from the abortions, from the sick church you have there, the church that cannot preach righteousness, is not preparing anyone for the kingdom of God. He tells them to repent. In a dream, this past night, and again the Lord does ask me to turn my face to face the nation of the USA, but you see, the way he asks me to turn, then I always find that I'm now focused on Washington, D.C. So he really turns my face on D.C., their capital city. Of course, the judgment will strike the entire nation, but he makes me focus on the seat of power. The seat of power. Washington, D.C., the seat of power. That is the greatest seat of power globally. So this is a very significant event. And as he does that, turning my face to face them, then it draws my attention, draws my face now to Washington, D.C. This time around, I see now the Capitol Hill. That is where the Congress is, and also the U.S. Congress, U.S. Senate is. That is now the seat of power, where decisions and policies are made that affect the whole earth. Again, because they failed to repent in that dream, then I strike them with an earthquake. Again now, the right hand side of that dome, the right hand side of the dome collapses. So I mean, but this is a very significant hour in the church. These are very significant events. Because now that is the seat of power globally. So God Almighty, in His mercies, He has deemed it fit that now is the time for the USL to come into the fold to prepare for the glorious coming of the Messiah.